proud Vermonter. In fact, if I had a dime for every time Mr. Hope mentioned Vermont, I could buy the state of Vermont. But who would want to? He graduated from the University of Vermont in 2012 at the top of his class. From there, he applied for over 100 jobs in his home state. He was not accepted into any of them. They took one look at his cargo shorts and said, "No, thank you." Luckily for us, Vermont's loss was our gain. Because they couldn't look past his less than stellar fashion sense, they missed the opportunity to have an excellent teacher at their disposal with much more impressive qualities. One such quality is his uncanny ability to insult himself with no prompting. I barely have time to open my mouth before he interjects, I know, how can Mr. Hope have any friends?" Almost as impressive as his capability to be self-deprecating is his knack for relating to his students and challenging them not to be only better writers, but better people. I doubt, and I think I speak for the class here, that I will ever have a teacher, or perhaps meet another person, that is equally aggravating as he is inspiring and compassionate. And with that, please help me welcome a person who, as much as I hate to admit it, has been influential to not only me, but to all of his students in these last few years. Mr. Lafmer Hope.
Very simply says, "Hope you're doing a good job." And so I guess that was enough. That's what I needed, and so you either have Mr. Gideon to thank or to hate for why I'm still here. Now, I also have this theory that there was a community-wide conspiracy to break this curse on the English department, because everyone here, literally everyone here has been gracious and welcoming from my first day here. And so, what I now recognize is what I perceived as rejection from some of you was actually like this emotional coping mechanism to limit any attachment to a teacher who might just leave right away. Now, the rest of the class, though, it seems you had some instructions probably as part of this conspiracy to encourage me to stay, and so that I might break this curse. A lot of you gave me ideas for how to avoid this awesome place in Tobacco Valley. You read to the surrounding areas and you said, "Oh, you gotta try this, oh, you gotta try that." Pretty wonderful. You also routinely invited me to your extracurricular activities, not just to the events, but to the practices as well. Wrestling practice was the shortest practice I attended of all the ones I went to. Though it wasn't anyone's record in pinning someone. I held out a couple seconds longer. You demonstrated to me that this place can be a lot of fun, and you disproved the vote of nonsense that some people like to say that there's nothing to do here. You guys proved to me that there's a ton of awesome stuff to do here. So, LCHS Class of 2018, you are actually a large reason of why I stayed. I just had people mail me maple syrup. Does ship okay. And after I made it through that first year, I wanted to stick around to see you today, to see you graduate. So, you know, you didn't have to make me speak in front of everyone to do that today. So you're also special, though, outside of my opinion. You're the highest achieving class to graduate in recent memory. You led and lead in academics, athletics, activities, and service to the community, as you already mentioned. And super impressive class here. We actually might miss you. Now, and when some of you leave, there actually are bigger roles in this community that are left unfilled for a while. You are a special class, despite the statistics. So now I would like to take a moment to recognize each of you individually for the valuable people you are. But we don't have time for that. I'm probably also supposed to deliver some inspiring words for you to take with you. So I made some up. Here's my inspirational advice. One word. Care. If something is worth your time, care about it. Nerd out about it. Celebrate it. Find joy in it. If there's something that you have to do but you aren't too crazy about it, find a way to care about it. Do your best. Don't tangle yourself up with insignificant details. Care about what is most important. Many of you have already demonstrated your exceptional ability to care, exceptional with a capital XC, to do your best in this moment while keeping your eyes on long-term goals. Your exceptional record, exceptional with a capital XC, proves that a lot of you know how to care. Continue to do this and show the people around you how to care. Essentially, fight apathy. Or don't. Whatever. So going forward, I hope you care about yourselves and what you choose to do. As long as you care about yourselves and what you are doing, you will live a fulfilling life. Caring about yourself means respecting your body by not poisoning it, by staying active, by wearing a freaky seatbelt and other protective equipment, by surrounding yourself with people who support your healthy decisions. Caring about what you're doing means paying attention and always trying to find a better, more efficient way to accomplish tasks, as well as sharing this attitude of improvement and excellence with those around you. LCHS Class of 2018, care about you. And that's about as much as I'm going to get today. So I'm going to play a tune on the fiddle here, and
Yes.